How are you all, my grateful students? So today I am back with one more maths topic, and that is simplifying a fraction. So what do you mean by simplifying a fraction? It means to make the fraction as simple as possible. So let's start with today's topic. Here we go. So children, let's start our topic for the day, simplifying fraction. Okay, so children, as I said, simplifying fraction means to make the fraction as simple as possible. And you know what, children? Simplifying also called as reducing fraction. Yes, reducing the fraction into its lowest term or simplifying a fraction, both are same. So let's start. How do you know if a fraction is fully reduced? Writing a fraction in its simplest form means that the top and bottom numbers can no longer be divided by the same whole number exactly or evenly other than the number 1. So for example, children, the fraction 2 by 3 is fully reduced. And how? Because there isn't any whole number other than 1 that both 2 and 3 can be divided by without having a remainder. So, to simplify a fraction, divide the top and bottom by the highest number that can divide into both numbers exactly. I repeat, to simplify a fraction, divide the top and bottom by the highest number that can divide into both numbers exactly. So children, there are two methods to simplify a fraction. Now the first one, method 1. Try dividing both top and bottom of the fraction until you can't go any further. So here, this method is quite lengthy because you need to keep on dividing. So I will show this method with an example. So here I've taken a fraction 40 by 60. As you can see that I have divided 40 and 60 both by 10. And I got an answer that is 4 by 6. But still, this 4 by 6 is not in the simplest form or the lowest form. So I divided 4 by 6 again by 2. Yes, and now I got the fraction that is 2 by 3. Yes, 2 by 3 is now as in the lowest form, is in the reduced form, or you can say it is in the simplest form. So 2 by 3 is the simplified fraction for 40 by 60. Now method 2. In method 2, we divide both the top and bottom of the fraction by their greatest common factor, or we can say by their highest common factor. In short form, we say GCF or HCF. Yes, children, this method is quite easy and very quick. So, in this method, you need to follow 3 steps. In first step, you need to list down all the factors of the numerator and denominator. So here I've taken 9 by 33 as my example. So I've listed down all the factors for 9 and 33. As you can see, the factors for 9 are 1, 3 and 9. And for 33, it's 1, 3 and 11. Now, second step. In the second step, you need to circle all the common factors. So, since 1 and 3 are the common, I've circled both of them. Now, the third step is you need to find out GCF and you need to divide both the numerator and the denominator by their greatest common factor. So, since out of 1 and 3, the greatest common factor for 9 and 33 is 3. So, I divided 9 and 33 by 3. And yes, I got my answer. It's 3 by 11. Yes, 3 by 11 is the simplified fraction. So children, there is one more way to list down the GCF or the greatest common factor, and that is by using T-chart method. So this is T-chart method. Okay, here I have taken my example that is 16 by 24. As you can see that the T shape, or you can say it's a T chart method, where I've listed down all the factors for 16 and 24. Yes, 1 into 16 is equals to 16. Yes, so 1 and 16 are the factors for 16. 2 8s are 16. 2 and 8 are the factors for 16. Now 4 into 4 is equals to 16. Yes, 4 is also the factor for 16. So here, as you can see children, the common factors are 1, 2, 4 and 8. I repeat, it's 1, 2, 4 and 8. Since 8 is the GCF, greatest common factor of 16 and 24, my last step is to divide both the numerator and the denominator by 8. Yes, I got my answer, and it's 2 by 3. Yes, 2 by 3 is the simplified fraction for 16 by 24. Yeah, that was quite easy and interesting. So children, I hope you understood how to simplify a fraction. So I'm going to send you one worksheet related to it. You need to solve that. Okay, till then, bye, see you, take care.